गुड मॉर्निंग मंडल, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज जेट ट्रांसफॉर्म्स। बिफोर गोइंग टू जेट ट्रांसफॉर्म्स, लेट अस हैव अ रिकैप ऑफ व्हाट यू हैव डन इन सिग्नल्स एंड सिस्टम्स कोर्स। ओके, व्हेन कंटीन्यूअस टाइम फॉर ए ट्रांसफॉर्म विल एग्जिस्ट फॉर ए सिग्नल? कंटीन्यूअस टाइम फॉर ए ट्रांसफॉर्म, कंसीडर ए सिग्नल एक्स ऑफ टी, एक्स ऑफ एफ इक्वल्स टू इंटीग्रल माइनस इनफिनिटी टू प्लस इनफिनिटी x of t e power minus j 2 pi f t dt. In order to have this function to exist, we need to satisfy this condition, right? X of t should be absolutely summable for uniform convergence of this ctft. This should be absolutely summable or absolutely integrable. This should be finite. Integral mod x of dt should be finite, and then this will converge uniformly under each time Fourier transform. Some signals won't have continuous time Fourier transform, but they have Laplace transform, right? Some signals may not have continuous time Fourier transform, but Laplace transform exists for them, right? That is the purpose of Laplace transforms we have used even in control systems. Control systems course, you might have seen stability analysis, right? For stability analysis, you gone through Laplace transform, right? You not approach this one because continuous time Fourier transform won't exist for unstable systems. Laplace transform can exist for unstable systems also. Can exist for unstable systems also. That's why you approach to Laplace transform, right? For stability analysis. Similarly, in the similar manner, we are having jet transforms in place of DTFT in our discrete case. For DTFT to exist, DTFT means x of e power j omega equals to sigma n equals to minus infinity to plus infinity x of n e power minus j omega n. In order to have uniform convergence, for uniform convergence, this should be absolutely summable, right? The sequence should be absolutely summable. It means this should be finite. This should be absolutely summable. Then you can say this will converge uniformly. This is for DTFT. Can someone answer me what is the DTFT for 0.2 whole power n into u of n? What is the DTFT for this? This is my x of n. What is the DTFT? I can answer. There no problem. What is the DTFT for this? Okay, what are the DTFT for a power n u of n? You can respond. What are the DTFT for a power n into u of n?
1 by 1 minus a into e power
j. Okay, 1 minus a into e power j omega. There is some condition, right? When mod a should be less than 1. Mod a should be less than 1, then this will converge and you are going to have something like this when mod a less than 1. Here a equals to 0.2, it means mod a equals to 0.2, right? Which is less than 1. I can go for this, right? 1 by 1 minus 0.2 into e power minus j omega. There is no issue with this one. Now can someone answer why the DTFT for minus 0.9 whole power n into u of n? What is the DTFT for this? 1 by n to verify this, that's it. Mod a should be less than 1. Is mod a less than 1 for this? A equals to minus 0.9, right? Mod a equals to 0.9, which is less than 1. I can go with this, right? 1 minus a. A means minus 0.9. Minus or minus means plus. 0.9 into e power minus j omega. is a DTFT for this. Now, what is the DTFT for 2 power n into U of n? What is the DTFT for this? Will it exist? Sigma n equals minus infinity plus infinity x of n into e power minus j omega n. X of n means 2 power n into u of n equals to 1 for all n greater than or equal to 0, otherwise that is 0, right? That's why I can go with 0 to infinity, 2 power n into e power minus j omega n. This is an infinite summation, right? You are having series, this is a series. You are going to add infinite terms. Will it converge or will it diverge? What is A in this case? A equals to 2, right? For convergence, we require mod A to be less than 1, right? This is required. But in this case, mod A equals to 2, which is above 1, right? This won't converge, this will diverge. DTFT won't exist. DTFT won't exist for this sequence, 2 power n into u of n. For this sequence, that won't exist, DTFT. Okay, this can be resolved as follows. I'll try to give that straight away. DTFT of x of n, let me consider x of n as follows. Two power n into u of n, this is my x of n. It means a power n u of n, where a equals to 2 in this case. Exist, it won't exist. Then what about DTFT for this? X of n into r power minus n, where r is some real number. R is some real number. Okay, let me consider this as positive real number. What about DTFT for x of n into r power minus n? Let us have a look into this one. DTFT for x of n into DTFT for x of n means 2 power n u of n into r power minus n. I want to look into this DTFT. Can someone help me? How to write this expression, DTFT for this? This is x of n, this is my x of n. Can I simplify this term? Is it 2 by r whole power n or 2 r whole power n? Is it okay, this one? R power minus n means 1 by r whole power n. I'm just clubbing these two things, 2 by r whole power n into u of n. Equal to 0. This is equal to 0 for n less than 0, right? That's why I'm going from 0 to infinity. Into e power minus j omega n. This is my DTFT of this one. Okay, when this will converge? Zero to infinity, I can write something like this, right? 2 by r into e power minus j omega whole power n. I can write like this, there is no issue with that. Okay, when this will converge? is something like a power n u of n dTFT for a power n u of n, where a equals to 2 by r, where a equals to 2 by r. Yeah, can someone answer when this will be equal to this one? 1 minus?
When r is greater than 2.
When r is greater than 2. How you said that one? A power n u of n means mod a to be less than 1, right? Mod a to be less than 1 means mod 2 by r to be less than 1 implies mod r should be greater than 2, right? Mod r should be greater than 2. If I have mod r greater than 2, then DTFT for this sequence will exist, right? That will exist. This is my x of n. This is my x of n, where this x of n don't have DTFT. What I did is, I just multiplied this x of n with r power minus n. And after that, I am applying DTFT for this combined one, this sequence. I am able to get DTFT for this one with this constraint. When mod r greater than 2, I can have this one, right? When mod r greater than 2. It's possible. This is required, right? Okay, can someone answer? X of n equals to, let me consider 3 power n u of n. What about DTFT for this one? Will it exist? Will it exist or not? DTFT for this. Will it exist DTFT for this? See, this is mod a greater than 1, right? Mod a equal to 3 here, which is above 1. Mod a should be less than 1 for convergence. DTFT won't exist. Can you just tell me for what values of r the DTFT exists?
Mod r greater than 3.
Yes, when mod r greater than 3, the DTFT exists. DTFT for this one, that will exist. It means I'm trying to multiply with some decaying sequence, right? This is a decaying sequence. And I'm trying to multiply with some decaying sequence so that that infinite summation will converge. It's an infinite summation, right? That will converge with the help of this factor. I'm reducing this value, right? That's what I am doing. Okay, and one more question I want to ask. Let me write like this. Suppose DTFT for x of n into r power minus n exists for for example branch 2, 2 comma infinite. If this is the case, DTFT is existing for this 2 comma infinite region. For example, this open interval 2 to infinity. If I give something like this one, then what about DTFT for x of n? Will it exist or it won't exist? Suppose DTFT for this exists only for r belongs to open interval 2 to infinity. Then what about DTFT for x of n? Will it exist or it won't exist? Exist for this interval. See, when this one is equal to DTFT of x of n, for what value of r?
One,
right? If r equal to 1, this is nothing but DTFT of x of n. If r equal to 1, this is nothing but DTFT of x of n, right? 1 whole power minus n is 1 always. And these two are equal, right? But in this case, it's not part of our region of convergence, right? This is known as region of convergence. See, if it shows that the DTFT for this sequence exists only when r belongs to 2 comma infinity, 2 to infinity. It means for r equal to 1, this will diverge according to this statement. For r equal to 1, this is diverging means DTFT for x of n won't exist. For DTFT of this particular x of n won't exist, right? This particular x of n, it won't exist. Okay, and one more thing. Suppose I have given to you something like this, DTFT of x of n into r power minus n exists only for r belongs to 0.2 comma infinity. 0.2 comma infinity. Then what about the DTFT for x of n? Will it exist? Will it exist or it won't exist?
Exists,
right? Because for r equal to 1 also, this will converge according to this statement. But if I substitute r equal to 1, that's part of r was, right? Region of convergence. DTFT of x of n, that will exist. There is no issue with this one. Okay, what about this? Now, if I try to replace then with 0.9, will it exist DTFT? DTFT of x of n, will it exist? This is my region of convergence of this one. Then what about DTFT for x of n, will it exist?
No,
yeah, I can speak out. Right? No, right? Yes, it won't exist because r equal to 1 is not part of this ROC. See, whenever r equal to 1, this statement corresponds to DTFT of x of n exists. Whenever r equal to 1. But r equal to 1 is not part of region of convergence, then I can say it won't exist. Won't exist, right? In this case. Suppose if I mentioned 0.2 to 1.1, for example, then r equal to 1 is part of r over c. Then if I substitute r equal to 1, that will exist, right? DTFT will exist. Yeah, this is a brief introduction. Okay, let me go back to this jet transforms. It's a motivation for jet transforms. The DTFT, it means the discrete time Fourier transform of a sequence x of n is as follows. You can have a look into this one. It's an infinite summation, right? Infinite series summation. And the jet transform of the sequence x of n is defined as follows. Sigma n equals to minus infinity plus infinity x of n into z power minus n. Same as this. Both are infinite series only, right? This is our Z transform, x of Z equals to sigma n equals to minus infinity plus infinity, x of n into Z power minus n, where Z is some complex number. It can be a complex number. I'll try to follow this notation. I'll try to print this complex number z as follows. z equal to r into e power j omega. We have already seen this, right? X plus j y equals to r e power j theta, where this is the complex number, right? Real part and imaginary part. That I can write as follows. Like this, right? In place of theta, I am using omega just for my convenience. That's what I am doing here. It's a polar form, right? R equals j theta. Z equal to r e power j omega. If you substitute this into this expression, then what is x of it we are going to get? R e power j omega. If I substitute this one, then I'm going to get r power minus n into e power minus j omega n. R power minus n into e power minus j omega n. Then what is this? You might have already seen this, right? Yeah, what is this? DTFT of x of n into r power minus n, right? This is nothing but discrete time Fourier transform for x of n into r power minus n. This is my z transform. If this converges for r equal to 1, if this converges for r equal to 1, then DTFT also exists, right? If this converges for r equal to 1, it means for r equal to 1, this is x of n into e power minus omega n. R e power j omega. And there is some network issue. Are you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
That's fine. Z equal to r into e power j omega. It's a complex quantity, right? It means I can represent this with the help of a complex plane. Complex plane means this is my real part and this is my imaginary part. Real axis and imaginary axis. Like that you can think. And for example, just consider r equal to 1. Just for our convenience, I am considering r equal to 1. With r equal to 1, z is nothing but e power j omega. For r equal to 1, right? E power j omega. Then what is mod z? What is mod z? What is magnitude of this?
One.
Mod z equals to 1, right? Yeah, that's fine. Mod z equal to 1. In this case, if z equals to r into e power j omega, where r is some non-negative number, then mod z equals to r. If r is some non-negative real number, here mod z will be r. In this case, mod z equals to 1, right? Mod z equal to 1 represents a circle. It's a circle, right? Just to clarify you. One implies that root x square plus y square equals to 1. Implies x square plus y square equals to 1.
Sir, it is not presenting, sir.
Okay. Okay, it's not presenting. Okay, that's fine. I'll share this once again. Okay, now is it okay? Okay, are you able to see this screen?
Yes, sir. It's visible.
Oh, yeah, that's fine. See, z equals to x plus jy, where x is real part of z, y is imaginary part of z. Mod z equal to 1, right? According to this one. If I consider z equals to e power j omega, if z equals to e power j omega, then mod z equals to 1. Mod z is nothing but root x square plus y square equals to 1. Implies x square plus y square equals to 1. This circle, right? This circle with a center 0, 0 and radius equals to 1. Radius equals to 1, right? I want to represent that one, mod z equal to 1. It means that's a unit circle. It's a real part means x, imaginary part means y, right? That's a unit circle. I'm going to get something like this. Yeah, this circle. Yeah, I cannot written properly. This radius is, this radius corresponds to 1. This corresponds to mod z equals to 1. Circle with a center of 0, 0 and radius equal to 1. This is a unit circle. Mod z equal to 1 represents unit circle. Okay, my claim is this one. If mod z equal to 1 is part of region of convergence of x of z, then DTFT of x of n exists. Is it true or false? Based on our discussions, can you try to justify this? This is my claim. My x of z corresponds to this, right? Sigma n equals to minus infinity to plus infinity x of n into z power minus n, where this is equals to r power minus n e power minus j omega n. My claim is this one. If mod z equal to 1 is part of ROC, region of convergence, mod z equals to 1 means z equal to r e power j omega implies mod z equals to r, right? Mod z equals to r. It means r equal to 1 is part of region of convergence. If this is part of region of convergence, it means that the transform exists for r equal to 1. If I claim like that, for r equal to 1, that is nothing but DTFT, right? Implies DTFT exists. It's true. Okay, let me go back to this one. For r equal to 1 case, can someone tell me what is this value? Z equal to e power j omega. Let me call this like angle omega. See my angle. This is my radius. See, z equals to 1 into e power j omega. 1 corresponds to this radius and omega corresponds to angle, right? With respect to this positive real axis. This is omega. Like that, you can imagine. Then this is nothing but my Z. This is Z plane, right? Z equal to e power j omega. This is nothing but Z, which is equal to e power j omega. What is this value? Can someone answer? Is it mod Z equal to 1? What is this? So omega equal to 0, right? At omega equal to 0, Z equal to e power j 0. E power j 0 means equals to 1, right? Then what about this? Yeah, now we can speak out. This is my omega. Omega equals to pi by 2. Then what is this Z value?
J.
E power j pi by 2 means?
Sin pi by 2
plus j sin pi by 2. Yeah. Cos pi by 2 plus j sin pi by 2. Sin pi by 2 is 1. It means this is j. Then what about this one? My omega is pi. It's pi radians, right? I'm covering pi radians. E power j pi. E power j pi means cos pi plus j sin pi. Cos pi means minus 1. J sin pi means 0. This is minus 1 plus 0, right? This is minus 1. Minus 1 plus j 0. And what about this one? This is 3 pi by 2. You can have a look into this one. This is 3 pi by 2. Pi by 2, pi by 2 plus pi by 2. 3 pi by 2. E power j 3 pi by 2 equals to cos 3 pi by 2 plus j sin 3 pi by 2. Then what is this?
Minus j.
This is minus j. Yeah, this is minus j. And this is 1. Once again, after 2 pi rotation, I'm coming back to same location, right? This is omega equal to 0. At omega equal to 0, this Z value. Once again, after 2 pi rotation, this is periodic, right? Every 2 pi, this will repeat. I'm covering 2 pi interval. I'm coming back to same location. E power j 2 pi means cos 2 pi plus j sin 2 pi, which is equals to 1 only. Same at this point. Once again, after 2 pi rotation, this will become e power j 4 pi. E power j 4 pi also 1, e power j 6 pi also 1, and so on. Due to periodicity of this e power j theta, right? It will repeat for every 2 pi, omega plus 2 pi k. That's same at that one. That's it. Can someone tell me what is this? Omega equals to pi by 4, then what is this point? Z equal to e power j pi by 4. E power j pi by 4 means? Cos pi by 4 plus j sin pi by 4 means 1 by root 2 plus j by root 2, right? Like that you can have. See, omega from 0 to 2 pi. 2 pi and 0 both are similar. There's no difference at all. It's just a view of that. Yeah. And the Z transform evaluated on the unit circle corresponds to Fourier transform. Z transform evaluated on the unit circle means mod Z equal to 1 we should consider. Mod Z equals to R according to our notation, because Z equals to R e power j omega. Mod Z equal to 1 only when R equal to 1. When you substitute R equal to 1, if that is converging, it means DTFT will exist, right? If Z transform evaluated on the unit circle, then that corresponds to DTFT or you can say Fourier transform. But that should be part of ROC. The mod Z equal to 1 should be part of region of convergence of Z transform. See, Z transform may not exist for all values of Z, as we have seen some example, right? Yeah. Let me give you some example for this. Let me consider x of n equals to 2 power n u of n. DDFT won't exist for this one. DDFT won't exist. What about Z transform? Where Z equals to R e power j omega, right? That's what we are claiming. Some complex number. 2 by z whole power minus n whole power plus n, or again say sigma n equal to 0 to infinity 2 z power minus 1 whole power n. This is equals to 1 by 1 minus 2 z power minus 1 for what values? Magnitude of this one should be less than 1, right? For mod 2 into z power minus 1 to be less than 1. It should be less than 1 implies mod z should be greater than 2. Mod z should be greater than 2. When I satisfy this condition, then this will converge or this will exist, this closed form expression. Otherwise that may diverge, right? That will diverge. This is known as ROC, region of convergence of z transform. For mod z less than r equals to 2, this won't exist. This will diverge. For mod z greater than 2, this will converge. Now you can see, mod z equal to 1 is not, this not part of this ROC, right? This is region of convergence. Here mod z equal to 1 is not part of ROC. So we can say that DTFT won't exist right away for this. That won't exist, right? Then what about Z transform for this 1 by 2 whole power n into u of n? Can someone answer me what is the Z transform for this? Yeah, what is the Z transform for this? 1 by 1 minus 1 by 2 into Z power minus 1. See, if we have doubt, we can simply expand this. N equal to 0 means 1 by 2 Z power minus 1. N equal to 1 means, see, N equal to 0 means 1. Whole power 0 means 1. If you have doubt, you can do this. 1 by 2 Z power minus 1 plus 1 by 2 Z power minus 1 whole square plus and so on. This is equal to this one. When? What is that condition? Mod 1 by 2 z power minus 1 should be less than 1. Implies mod z should be greater than 1 by 2, right? Mod z should be greater than 1 by 2. Okay, then what about this one? Will it include unit circle in this? Mod z greater than 1 by 2, then what about mod z equal to 1? Is it part of ROC? Can you speak out? Yeah, that's part of ROC, right? Mod z equals to 1 is part of ROC because ROC here is mod z greater than 1 by 2. Mod z equal to 1 means that is above 1 by 2 only, right? It's a part of ROC. It means DTFT exists for this one. If you want DTFT for this one, I can simply substitute z equal to e power j omega. Z equal to e power j omega in this one. Here, mod z equals to 1 is in ROC, in region of convergence only, right? Now, I can find the DTFT as follows. X of e power j omega equals to, if I satisfy this condition, then only I can do this trick. z equal to e power j omega. I simply replace z with e power j omega. Then this will become e power minus j omega, right? 1 by 1 minus 1 by 2 into e power minus j omega. Because of this fact, this is in part of ROC, right? But here I can't do in the same manner. I can't simply replace z with e power j omega in order to get DTFT. Because mod z equal to 1 is not part of this ROC, right? Because this above 2, mod z is always above 2, ROC. But we require mod z equal to 1. It's not part of ROC. So we can't do that trick here. But here you can do that trick. Z equal to e power j omega in this expression. In order to get the DTFT. Due to this fact, this is in ROC. And then, can you answer this one? X of n equals to a power n, u of n. Then what is the z transform for this? Because u of n equal to 0 for n less than 0, I am removing that part. This will be a power n, z power minus n. That equals to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity a z power minus 1 all power n. This equals to 1 by 1 minus a z power minus 1 only when mod a z power minus 1 less than 1 implies I need mod z greater than mod a, right? This is my ROC, region of convergence. If I satisfy this condition, then I can have closed form expression like this. Otherwise, I won't have closed form expression for this one. Okay, that's fine. These are some of the examples. For example, if you consider x of n equals to u of n, this is not absolutely summable, as we already saw in DTFT examples. Therefore, Fourier transform will not converge uniformly. That will not converge uniformly, right? For this sequence. We have seen some other trick, right? In order to find DTFT for u of n, we separated the DC part and we did some manipulation, right? For the DC part, we are representing in terms of analog impulses, that transform. We applied some trick for that one. Okay, that's fine. Let me go with some other example. Can try to find z transform for the sequence minus 2 power n into e power minus n minus 1. When this will be equal to 0? When this will be equal to 0? This thing. Or what values?
For n less than minus 1.
Yes. For n less than minus 1, this is equal to 0. Otherwise, this is equal to 1, right? For n less than minus 1, this is equal to... Oh, is it true or false? N less than minus 1...
N greater than minus 1, sir.
Yes. or n greater than minus 1 is equal to 0. Otherwise, that's equals to 1, right? Otherwise, that's equals to 1. Equals to 1 else. Like that you can have. It means that I'll try to have like this. N equals to minus infinity to minus 1. You see, minus 2 power n is equals to 1 in this interval, right? Yeah. Up to minus 1, this is equals to 1. Up to minus 1. Above minus 1, this is equal to 0. That's why I can start only up to minus 1. Minus 2 power n into 1 by default into z power minus n. N equals to minus infinity to minus 1. Already have minus outside this summation. And this is 2 z power minus 1 whole power n. Yes, what is the simplification for this?
We can interchange.
Yeah, what is the simplification? Okay, let me start with minus 1. I'll try to go downwards, up to down, like that. For z equals to, for n equals to minus 1, what is this for n equal to minus 1? 2 z power minus 1 whole power minus 1. 2 z power minus 1 whole power minus 1 means 1 by 2 into z, right? 1 by 2 into z. For n equals to minus 2, I am going downwards towards minus infinity, right? For n equals to minus 2, this will become like whole power minus 2. Whole power minus 2 means 1 by 2 whole square z power minus 2. Oh, z power 2, right? 1 by 2 whole square z power 2. And what about third term? 1 by 2 z whole power 3. Yeah, this can be rewritten as follows. See, 1 by 2 z whole square plus 1 by 2 z whole cube plus 1 by 2 z whole power 4 plus and so on. Like this again, right? Now, what is the simplification for this? I have something like this. 1 by 2 z plus 1 by 2 z whole square plus 1 by 2 z whole cube plus and so on. Then what is this? Equals to? Okay, what is this? Yeah,
a
how to write?
1 minus.
Okay, A by?
1 minus R.
Okay, A by 1 minus R, right? Okay, here A,
where A is 1 by 2Z.
Yeah, 1 by 2Z. Divided by 1 minus, that factor also 1 by 2z, right? 1 by 2z. Yeah, I'll try to simplify this further. So it become like, yeah, what will be this? Is it okay? I'm simplifying like this. Is it okay or any mistake is there in this? See, what I have done is I just multiplied with 2. After multiplication with 2, we are going to get z by 2 minus z, right? Z by 2 minus z. After that, I multiplied with z power minus 1. Implies this will become 1. 1 by, yes, minus I am getting, right? 1 by 2 z power minus 1 minus 1, which is nothing but minus 1 by 1 minus 2 z power minus 1. And I have another minus outside, right? Minus or minus is plus, which is equals to implies x of z equals to 1 by 1 minus 2z power minus 1. But with the constraint of mod z, yeah, what is the constraint? When this will converge? Mod 1 by 2z should be less than 1, right? This term should be less than 1, mod 1 by 2z. Implies mod z should be less than 2. Mod z should be less than 2. This is the ROC. Mod z should be less than 2. This is the ROC I am going to get. Okay, let me summarize these two statements. 2 power n u of n implies 1 by 1 minus 2 z power minus 1, where mod z greater than 2. And 2 power n u of minus n minus 1 implies z transform of this one is, once again, same thing. There is no difference. They are identical. But ROC is different, right? ROC is mod z less than 2. It means this plays a crucial role, right? ROC is very important. Because, see, if I simply gave you something like this, if I gave you x of z equals to 1 by 1 minus 2z power minus 1, and if I ask you, what is my sequence x of n? This need not be unique, the sequence you are going to get, unless I mentioned ROC. I mean, this is must. ROC should be must. If I say that mod z greater than 2, then you can say x of n equals to 1 by 1 minus 2 z power minus 1. No, x of n equals to, pardon? 2 or n you want it. If I say subject equal to this and mod z less than 2, then you answer x of n equals to minus 2 power n into u of minus n minus 1. It means ROC is very much important for our case, the z transform scenario. Without this, it is incomplete. It means if I ask you to compute z transform for this sequence, and if you answered only up to this part, you will get 0 marks. If you answer only up to this part, you should mention along with ROC. ROC is must. This should be there along with this one. Okay, now can you try to answer this? A power n. Yeah, in the similar lines you can try, right? What is the transform for this? See, in place of 2, we have A. We just replaced 2 with A. Then what is this? One by one minus A, z power minus 1, and ROC should be right-sided. It's right-sided, right? Mod z greater than 2. It means mod z greater than mod A. Mod z greater than mod A. And if I consider minus A power N, u of minus n minus 1, the transform for this one also same, 1 by 1 minus a z power minus 1, but this is left sided, mod z less than mod a. This is left sided sequence, right? This is going till minus infinity. This sequence will go till the index n equals to minus infinity. This sequence will go till the index n equal to infinity, right? It's a right sided sequence, it's a left sided sequence. For left sided sequence, we got ROC something like mod z less than something, right? For right sided, we got like mod z greater than something. Like that, we got. Okay, now can someone answer what is the z transform for 0.2 whole power n u of n? Yeah, you can speak out. What is the z transform for this? You can look into this and answer. Yeah, what is the transform for 0.2 whole power n u of n. Yeah, can you speak?
1 by 1 minus 0.2 z power minus 1.
Yes, 1 by 1 minus 0.2 z power minus 1. With
margin with greater than 0.2.
Yes, with margin greater than 0.2, right? With margin greater than 0.2. It means ROC contains margin equal to 1. I can find the DTFT with the help of this one. I can simply replace z equal to e power j omega to get my DTFT for this scenario. Because margin equal to 1 is part of my ROC, right? Then what about 0.2 whole power n minus u of minus n minus 1? What is the z transform for this? 1 by 1 minus 0.2 into z power minus 1 once again with mod z greater or less?
Less than, sir.
Yes, this is less than 0.2, right? Okay, now it's fine. What about DTFT? Can I find DTFT by replacing z with e power j omega here? Is it possible? You can look into this and answer.
Yes, sir.
No, it's not possible. Mod z equal to 1 is not part of ROC, right? Mod z should be less than 0.2. But for DTFT to exist from this, margin equal to 1 should be part of ROC. That's not part of ROC. It means DTFT won't exist for this sequence. That won't exist, right? Because margin equal to 1 is not part of ROC. Hey, that exists. Okay, now 3 power n u of n. What is z transform for this? 3z power minus 1. With mod z greater than 3. And if I consider minus 3 power n u of minus n minus 1, it will be 1 by 1 minus 3 z power minus 1 with mod z less than 3. Okay, can I find DTFT by substituting z equal to e power j omega here in this case? Is it possible?
No, sir.
It's not possible because margin equal to 1 is not part of ROC. This will diverge as well. And what about this second case? Can I get DTFT by substituting?
Yes,
we can get, right? Because margin equal to 1 is part of this ROC. Because margin less than 3, right? When margin equal to 1, that's less than 3 only. That's it. Okay, now can you try to find z transform for this? Let me have 0.3 whole power n u of n minus 1.2 whole power n u of minus n minus 1. Yeah, what is x object? The linearity applies here also. There is no issue with that. Yeah, what is z transform for this? For this part. 1 by 1 minus 0.3 z power minus 1 with ROC. Mod z, is it greater or less?
Greater than.
Yes, good. It's greater than 0.3. And plus, if I find z transform for this one, this will be 1 by 1 minus 1.2 z power minus 1 with ROC for this one, mod z less than, this is left sided sequence, right? 1.2. Okay, it's fine. let me have that graphical view of this one. You see my z plane. This is mod z equal to 1. Mod z equals to 1. Those are circles, right? If I have z equals to r e power j omega, where r is some positive real constant, implies mod z equal to r. It's a circle with radius r, with a center of 0. This is x plus j y, right? Mod x plus j y means root x square plus y square equals to r. Implies x square plus y square equals to r square. Circle with center 0, 0 and radius r. This is the meaning of that. Mod z equal to r means. Now, in our example, mod z should be 0.3 and mod z should be less than 1.2. Somewhere here. This is mod z equal to 1 means this will be 1. So radius 1, right? 0.3. Mod z equals to 0.3 means this is a circle. What I need is mod z greater than 0.3. This is my region of convergence. Mod z greater than 0.3. And let us go to the second one. Mod z should be less than 1.2. Mod z should be less than 1.2. 1.2 somewhere above 1, right? This is 1.2. This corresponds to mod z equals to 1.2 circle. Here, mod z should be less than 1.2, right? Less than 1.2 means inside this circle, right? Then what is the common ROC for both of them? There is some intersection, right?
In between,
right?
0.3 and 1.2.
Yes, in between 0.3 and 1.2, right? They are intersecting in between 0.3 and 1.2. This is my common ROC. That ring, right? That's some sort of ring. Okay, is it including mod z equal to 1? Is my ROC, this is my final ROC.
Yes, sir.
That includes mod z equal to 1, right? It means I can find DTFT for this one with the help of z equal to e power j omega. I can replace z with e power j omega to get my DTFT for this. That way I can find, right? Okay, let me go to another example. X of n equals to, okay, 2 power n into u of n plus 1.2 whole power n. Okay, let me already avoid some confusions. Minus 1.4 power n u of minus n minus 1. Can someone tell me what is the z transform for this? What about first? 2 power n u of n. 1 by 1 minus 2 z power minus 1 with ROC. What is the ROC for this? Margin?
Margin.
Yes, margin greater than 2. That's fine. And second one, when coming to second one, 1 by 1 minus 1.2 z power minus 1. And the ROC for this one is, what is the ROC for this? Margin?
Margin less than 1.2.
Margin less than 1.2, right? Now, do you think this is feasible? I need to satisfy and. I need to satisfy margin greater than 2 and margin less than 1.2. Is it possible to have something like this?
No, sir.
It's not possible, right? Here, z transform won't exist. it won't exist. Because there is no common ROC between this and this, right? Z transform won't exist for this one. Because there is no common values of Z where both of them will exist. If this is existing, this won't exist. If this is existing, this first one won't exist. Both can't exist at the same time, right? For same Z value. There is no, not even single Z, right? Which will satisfy both of them. It means Z transform won't exist for this one. It won't exist. Okay, let me consider another one. Yeah, can someone answer what is the Z transform for this one? Yeah, you can speak. 2Z power minus 1 with an ROC of mod Z should be greater than 2 plus. Yeah, what is this? Yeah, now you can speak. What is Z transform for
this?
Minus, right? Yes. I'll go for minus. Because when that is minus of this one, I can simply go for 1 by 1 minus 3 Z power minus 1. Here minus is not there, right? I'll multiply with minus and I'll multiply once again with minus. Like that I can do, right? Mod Z should be less than 3. What about Z transform? Will it exist here? It's possible, right? Let me consider. This is mod Z equal to 2, this circuit. And this corresponds to mod Z equal to 3 circuit, the second one. Mod Z equal to 3, see mod Z equal to 2, mod Z equal to 3. Now, I can have above 2 and below 3, right? Above 2, below 3 means? This is my ROC. This is my ROC, region of convergence. Okay, Z transform exists. What about DTFT? Will it exist? DTFT?
No, sir.
It won't exist, right? Because mod Z equal to 1 is somewhere below this. It's not part of this ROC. The mod Z equal to 1. It means DTFT won't exist. Z transform, it exists for this, right? Okay, let me have another one. X of n equals to 2 power n u of n. 0.2 whole power n u of n, 5 power n u of n. Then what about x of z? Yeah. Can you give me compact thing finally? 2z power minus 1 plus 1 by 1 minus 0.2 z power minus 1 plus 1 by 1 minus 5 z power minus 1. What are the ROCs for each of them? What is the ROC for this? Mod Z? What is the ROC for this?
Greater than 2.
Mod Z greater than 2. And the ROC for this part corresponds to, and Mod Z should be greater than 0.2. Because all are right-sided sequences, right? And for this, Mod Z should be greater than 5. What is the combination of all the things? What is my final
ROC? Mod greater than 5.
Yes, it's good. Mod Z greater than 5. This is a common for everyone, right? Mod Z greater than 5. This is my final ROC. Now, do you think DTFT exists for this? With this ROC?
No,
sir. Yeah, because Mod Z equal to 1 is not part of ROC. And one thing you can observe is, when your entire sequence is, see, all of them are right-sided sequences, right? It's going till infinite index, n equal to infinity. It's also going till n equal to infinite index, right? It's also going till infinity. When all of them are right-sided sequences, your ROC also something like major greater than some value. Like that I can think, right? What about all of them are left-sided sequences? Let me consider minus n minus 1 and minus n minus 1. In that scenario, what happens to ROC?
More than less than 5.
Oh, is it less than 5? Or less than something else?
Less than this point.
Less than point, right? Yeah. That should be less than point. When R of them are left sided, the ROC you are going to get also something like this, right? Margin less than something. Like that you are getting. You can have some view of this. Okay. Is the ROC including, okay, pole we cannot discuss, right? Okay, that's fine. Let me stop recording.